buy into. And this is a starting process, really, in terms of sharing some ideas and some discussion today. And we will then take that information away and start to look at how we can start to progress this programme going forward. I actually think it's a very important programme in basis of keeping the depth, or improving the depth that we've got in Scotland, and also improving the quality of players coming through the system. And as Dan said yesterday as well, every so often we bring out a player in spite of the system. And I think what we've got to really start looking at now is looking at our own future and being masters of our own destiny through proper structured programmes with a lot of partnerships involved, coaches involved, coaches educated to be involved as well. And I think if we do that, then we've got a chance of success, and more importantly, consistent success in maintaining it. We don't want to be in a situation that every 5, 6, 10 years somebody comes through the system. It's got to happen year in, year out. If we do that, I personally think in terms of GB, it could be very strong, because having looked at what's happening in England, Ireland, Wales, I'm not sure their structures are strong enough either. And I think if we can get our act together and move quickly and get something in place and do it properly, I genuinely believe we could start to influence age group programmes in GB, and then theoretically heavily influence GB senior programmes in the future. That's only good for us in terms of continued funding from Sport Scotland, having more ownership of UK sport funding and that goes in the future as well. And I think those things we shouldn't forget, they're actually really important to us. So what I'm going to do is hand over to Dan. We want to make this interactive, we want people's opinion. Some of it might be quite controversial, so it would be good to get feedback from you, and just put up your hand if you've got a question for the presentation.
Cheers, Dan. I'm just going to sit during this because when I was standing up, top of my back, being as old as I am today. Right, as you can see, it says it's a draft document. I'll show you the matrices that we've done at the present time, but you can just read it, I'm sure, and I'm sure you would rather read it than listen to me, but we're just going to take you through it. I'm just going to move down quite slowly so that nothing escapes you. But the first thing is to understand that it's going to come up in a wee minute. There are all the things about the coach. Right, but although it says at the bottom there, these coaches will be selected by the high performance coach, the performance director, this will be a document that you can use. Because if somebody comes to you and they are year one of their badminton life, it doesn't matter what age they are, you can take them through this structure. I think that was a deliberate. You got a yellow card there. You want these?
A professional foul, Dan.
But it's not. I actually thought it was on the first page, I'm not sure if it is. Yes, there it is. This document is not for kids who want to play for fun. Right? You must understand that. This is a high performance document. So, although there's stuff in here you can use and kids can use it and enjoy it, it is a high performance thing. So there will be measurable stages throughout this where the kids have to be shown progress. So it's all going to be measurable, and you'll see it as we move through it. As you can see, it is the stairway and it is not completed. Right, you've made the first step, but it's not completed. So there it says there, when they start at 10 at the beginning, but if a kid comes to you at 14, but their badminton years are 0 to 2, and they're keen to try and do this, then you have to start where this says you're going to start. Or you should start. And it's then down to the coach working with them, although I'm sure